when phrases like, well, you don't look disabled, exist, of course we have to come out as disabled. Hello, my name's Max, and if you're new here, I'm disabled. And most days, I have to come out as such. I am disabled in a multitude of ways. I have a condition called ehlers-danlos syndrome, which is a connective tissue disorder, which means my bones dislocate, more specifically my joints dislocate. It causes chronic pain, and there is a whole host of issues that aren't dislocations. I also have an invisible illness called postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. I have an allergy to the cold, known as cold urticaria, which means I can't breathe outside. I am deaf, and I have a visual impairment called visual snow syndrome, and I sit on the deaf-blind spectrum. I think that's everything. And I have to come out as disabled all of the time. Shall we begin with a fun story that's not really that fun? I think we should. Throwback to about 2017, I was newly in a wheelchair and dating. I'm also queer too, if you can see the flags in the background. So I was on Tinder, and this was when the wheelchair was very, 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 very new, as in I had started talking to someone when I wasn't in a wheelchair, and naively I didn't bring it up. Yeah, catfish, whatever. Learned from that lesson. I didn't have any pictures of me in my wheelchair on Tinder, on my profile, or any of my social media because it was really just new. And so I turned up to the date in my wheelchair, not really thinking anything of it. She turned up, saw me, said, "Sorry, I thought you were normal." Turned around and left. And it was at that point I knew that I needed to come out as a wheelchair user. Every time I spoke to a new person on that platform and took some selfies and put them in my little bio thing because apparently it was necessary. Dating as a disabled person is a very different video and we're not going to go into that today, but I had to come out as disabled on Tinder, on any dating platforms, just because otherwise things like that happened. And people deserve to know what they're getting into. Say the people that don't realise that disability can happen at any point. Also, a large portion of disabilities are invisible ones. That means that in order to get our access needs met, we have to tell a person that we are disabled because it is not obvious otherwise. Access needs aren't really obvious anyway, and there should always be a discussion. But the difference being, if I rock up in a wheelchair and there's a step to the front door, it's kind of obvious that I need a ramp compared to when I'm on foot. I need a place to sit, but nobody can tell unless I tell them. So I have to come out as disabled to tell them, "Hello, yes, I am disabled. I need a chair to sit down in because I will not last this entire time stood on my feet." And for those with invisible illnesses or invisible disabilities, we have to come out as disabled in order to have these conversations. Or, for example, disabled toilets. When I'm not in my wheelchair, I still often choose to use the disabled toilet because it has the grab rails, it has the space that I need, it has the supports, and it's just a lot easier for me to go and do my business in a disabled toilet because I do still struggle with mobility when I'm not in my wheelchair. And the amount of times I've had to explain myself when I come out and they're like, "Oh, you're not very disabled, are you?" Or, "Oh, that's actually the disabled toilet, that's not for you." And I'm like, "Actually, it is for me because I am disabled." We have to come out to use those things. Every time I need help with something, for example, last week in the dentist, I had a lovely scale and polish, if you can't tell, teeth are shiny. I could not hear anything the receptionist was saying because I'm deaf, and you can't always tell that I'm deaf because deaf doesn't have a look. I wasn't signing because they weren't signing and I'm not fluent enough to really get the point what I wanted to say. I just couldn't hear, so I had to tell them, oh, I'm deaf, please repeat or write it down. How are they gonna know? If I need help with something because I can't see, I'm having a bad day with visual snow syndrome, I need somebody to read something to me. I have to explain it to the person that I'm asking to read things to me. Every time I meet somebody new, I have to come out as deaf or deafblind to be like, oh hey, actually I can't understand what you're saying, can you please repeat it also a bit slower? Or could you please have the light facing you so I can see you a bit better? Or hey, can we please move somewhere else because it's too bright and I can't see. If I can't see, I can't hear. In every single job application, I have to specify that I am disabled. And there's multiple reasons why on a job application I will say that I am disabled. Number one, a lot of my leadership experience comes from coaching wheelchair basketball, which I will mention because it's relevant to the job application. Number two, I don't know what the interview spec is gonna be like. I don't know what the building is like. So even if I don't disclose, hey, I'm disabled, if they offer me an interview, I'm still going to have to contact them and ask, do you have step-free access? Do you have a lift? Do you have a hearing loop? Can I bring an interpreter, for example, when we get there? I have to out myself as disabled to get my access needs met. Likewise for events. If I want to go to a drag show, I will have to ask things like, is it a seated event? Do you have a disabled toilet? Is there step-free access? Is there a lift? Etc. And oftentimes I feel like I have to preface that with, hello, I'm disabled. Hello, I'm a wheelchair user. Hi, I'm deaf. Hi, I'm deafblind. I have to come out to get the answers to these questions. Even just asking, what is the accessibility like, is likely to out you as a disabled person. Challenging ableism also is likely to out you as a disabled person. If you highlight something and say, hey, actually, what you've just said there is actually quite ableist, and you really shouldn't do that. I don't really see many able-bodied people doing that. To have that claim taken seriously, it has to be relevant to you, apparently. Because I can't point out things that are audist or vidist without people saying, why do you care? Why does it matter? I'm talking to you, aren't I? I'm like, yeah, actually, I'm deafblind. This is affecting me, what you're saying and what you're doing. If you're highlighting an ableism issue that they don't perceive affects you, you have to clarify how it does. And then often deal with the ableism of, oh, but I couldn't tell. Wonderful, thank you. That helps. I'm suddenly cured. I'm not disabled anymore because I don't look it. Thank you for telling me. Internet discussions, for example, plastic straws. You can't defend plastic straws without being disabled yourself, of course. Oh boy. You know when there's a new product come out that's like, ah yes, hands-free chopper, electric can opener, and people are like, wow, this is for lazy people, and you're like, actually, hi, as a disabled person, this would very much help me. Especially with those with invisible disabilities, you do have to come out and say, yeah, I'm actually disabled and this will help me, not just, I would find this very helpful. Also with the great mask debate of the COVID pandemic, I know we love talking about it, but the amount of people that have had to out themselves as being disabled because they actually can't wear a mask and people are being really rude. Oh god. That's a thing that we didn't need. But here we are, forcing people to come out as disabled because you feel entitled to their medical history. And also when I started wearing a mask, I had to come out as disabled. More specifically, I had to come out as chronically ill because I don't necessarily class my cold urticaria as a disability, but a chronic illness. I had to come out all the time because people kept stopping me and asking me why I was wearing my mask, if they were polite enough to ask before insulting me. Is coming out as a disabled person the same as coming out as a queer person? No. But it's not super different. As a queer person, I also have to come out multiple times in my life. There is no one coming out story, no matter what you're coming out with. As a pagan, I have come out of the broom closet. As a queer trans person, I have come out of the closet. And as a disabled person, I have come out of the disability closet. Coming out isn't just for queer people, it's about any minority group that needs to come out. I, on a good day, pass as a totally healthy human being. You can't really tell, especially if I'm just wearing my sunglasses and I'm just outside and I have a good day with my pain, so I'm not using a crutch, a wheelchair, or a walking stick. If my hair's down, you can't see my hearing aids, and my sunglasses look like just regular run-of-the-mill sunglasses. I might pass as a perfectly able-bodied person. So, yeah, I do have to come out as disabled because it's relevant to my experience moving through the world and having the same access as everybody else. Should disabled people have to come out as disabled? No. No. Challenging ableism should not be the signifier that somebody is disabled. People asking for accessibility information shouldn't be like, ah yes, what is your disability? And forcing people to come out. Using a disabled toilet. You shouldn't be grilling people to come out to you with exactly what their disability is and how it affects them and why it makes them need a disabled toilet. The world should just be an accessible place so that we actually don't need to come out if we don't want to, because it's not always safe and we don't always want to, but a lot of the times it's necessary and relevant. So with that being said, don't forget to like this video, drop a comment down below if you have any thoughts and feelings, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time with at least one bonus video every single month. See you.